What's up, everybody? For me, college was one of the most fun times in my life because, I don't know, I just loved college. I mean, it was the first time that you're kind of living away and you're on your own and you're doing your own thing, and life's pretty much taken care of for you. You just, it's like summer camp, but for school or something. You know what I mean? I mean, you didn't have to really pay rent usually. Like, it was something your parents should take care of. So, anyways, I had a ton of great college memories. I'm gonna share one of them, a funny story. Sure, we all have great college stories. If you guys, if any of you guys make videos and you have a great college story, go ahead and make one and put it as a video response to here. But anyways, so I lived in, I went to school for a year out in Minnesota, and I lived in Colorado. And these small schools like that, everyone would go home like almost every weekend, or they go home every break and everything, and I couldn't really do that. So so I made good friends with people that stayed at school on those breaks, like, for example, my RA. So I became real good buddies with my RA, and we were both 21, and everyone else in our hall was like, you know, like freshman, sophomore, like they weren't even old enough to drink, you know. So one of his responsibilities, because this was a small private, like, Catholic school, you know, it was St. Mary's, and one of his jobs as an RA when on break was to go through people's fridge and make sure they didn't have alcohol, because, like, if you were 21, you were okay, you could have alcohol, but if you're underage, it was just, you know, whatever. It's just what they had to do. So when everyone would go home during break, it'd just be him and I, like, in the dorms, and it was like, you know, he's like, all right, dude, I got to do my runs and stuff, and his, you know, do all of his RA type duties, and I'd go and help him sometimes. And one of the things that we always would do was we'd take people's booze in their fridges. Excuse me. Like, the kids that were like 18 and stuff, and he was supposed to turn them in to the college, but we'd keep them for ourselves and drink it ourselves. And the best part about the story is, when everyone came back from, like, it was like Christmas break or something, when everyone came back and all the kids noticed they didn't have booze, excuse me, I was yawning and I didn't see, my eyes closed for a second, didn't see that pothole. When they came back from break, none of these kids had the nerve to come up to him and be like, hey, did you take our booze? And he's like, are you really asking me that question? How old are you? Like, are you serious? You know? Because it was a strict school. You weren't allowed to, you know, it's like a dry campus and everything. So, it was great, like, the nerve of these kids would come up and be like, well, I think you took my booze. And he's like, yeah, we did take your booze. You're not allowed to have it. You want me to turn you in, or what are you trying to do? So it was great. Fun times. Just a little college story for it, like, little memory. Taking people's booze and drinking it. It's different from stealing. I'm very anti-stealing. But that was like, that was us doing them a favor, because we could have turned their asses in. You know, like, do you get that? Like, you're supposed to confiscate the booze and then, like, you're supposed to tell them, the school, about it. But we just did them a favor and just drank it ourselves. Anyways, talk to you again.